Hello and welcome to the next part of creating e-commerce website tutorial. In the last video, you learned about creating responsive navbar of e-commerce website. Now we are going to create sidebar menu that will display all the product categories available on this online shopping website. Before starting, make sure to subscribe my channel so that you will never miss my new videos. Now let's start this tutorial. In the last video, we already made this navigation bar. Now we will add one sidebar menu over here. For that, I'll create one section here and one class name, header, now again we will add one div and the class name will be side menu. In this menu, we will add menu and submenu also. For that, we will use UL, and after that, we will write LI, and here I'll write menu text, that is on cell. Simply duplicate this one. And second one, I'll write mobiles. And the third one, computers. Now I will refresh my website so you can see three menu over here in the left side. Now we will add some icons just after this text. For that, I will go to the Font Awesome website again, and here we will search for icon. I'll search angle right. Just copy this one and paste it here. I'll paste this code in all three menu. Now you can see this icon after this menu text. Now we will add some menu for this one. Okay, for that we will use UL again and again LI. This will be the submenu text. Similarly, we will add this submenu on all the three menu. Just I will change this name, submenu 2, and for third one it will be submenu 3. Now I will refresh this website so you can see this menu and submenu also, but these all are aligned in the same line. Now I will copy this class name side menu, and let's come to the CSS file, and first of all we will write one comment here. And after that, we will put this class name. We will write height, width, font size, float left, z index 2, background color. Now I will refresh this one so you can see this menu width and height. Now again I will copy this class name here, and after that I'll write UL, and now I will write margin left to add some space from the left side. Again copy this one, and after that we'll put LI. List style type will be none. Font weight, margin top, cursor pointer. Again, I'll paste this here and after that I'll write hover color orange. So you can see the color over this menu when I will take cursor over this menu. Now we need to hide the submenu. For that I'll write this one here and we'll write display none z index 10 top 77 pixel. Now refresh this one. So you can see this menu over here and there is no submenu. Okay, now we will display this submenu whenever we will take cursor over this menu. For that we will write hover here and again display block height margin left and padding position fixed. And background. Box shadow also. Now I will refresh this page so you can see this submenu also when I will take cursor over this menu. Now I'll copy this class name for icon, paste it here, and here we'll write margin top, margin right, float right. Just we need to correct this one dot fa angle right. Okay, now I will refresh this website so you can see this icons on the right side. Similarly we will add multiple submenu and menu also on this website. So here you can see all the menu here and submenu also. When I will change this screen size so that you can see this sidebar menu is not responsive for now. So we need to make it responsive. For that again I will come to the CSS file and we will go here and we will copy this one media query. Paste it here. And here we will write code for small devices. Now I will put the class name here side menu for a small device. And for a small device the width will be 34%, z index 20, top position, font size. Now you can see this side menu is fully responsive for a small device also. Now we need to align this submenu for a small device. For that I'll write again this class name. And after that I'll write UL, LI and again UL. And here we'll write top 133 pixel. And when we'll hover this menu, then the submenu will be margin left 30%. Now again I will refresh this website so you can see this alignment is very good. Now just we need to change this margin left. I'll change it to 33%. Okay, we need to decrease So I'll make it 31%. Now you can see this is aligned very good. All this menu and submenu also, and it is fully responsive for small devices also. Now we need to hide this sidebar menu on mobile screen, and we will add one button that will be used to open and close this side menu on mobile device. For that, again I will come to the HTML file and we will add icon just above this logo. Okay, to search icon we will go to the Fontosum website again, and here I will search for icon bars. Just copy this code and paste it here. Okay, I will simply duplicate it and just change it to times. So this will be the second icon. Now I'll refresh my website so you can see this icon over here. Now we will hide this sidebar menu. For that I'll go to this code and here we will write display none. So now you can see there is no sidebar on this website whenever you will open this on a small device. Now we will put one ID for this menu icons. This menu icon also, and for this close icon also. And just copy this ID and let's go to the CSS, and here we will put this two ID and let's write font size margin color. Now you can see this color and font size for this icons. Now we will hide this icons. For that I'll write display none. So now you can see there is no icons over here. Now we will add this toggle option. For that we will write this one, on click is equal to open menu. And for this close button we will write on click is equal to close menu. Now I will copy this one and come down just above this closing body tag, and here we will write a script. Function and paste it here, open menu, and we will write document.getElementById. Now we will create one ID for this side menu. So here we will write ID is equal to side menu and copy this. Just paste it here, and for this side menu I'll write a style display block. Now simply duplicate this one and just change this ID to menu button, and the third one will be close button, and this one will be none. Now again I will copy and paste this one and change it to close menu, and this one none, block, and third one also none. After adding this code, I'll come to the CSS file. And here we will write this ID for a small device, and we will write display block. So now after refresh you can see this menu icon on this small device, And when I will click on this icon, you can see this sidebar menu also. And when I will click on this close icon, it will close this sidebar menu. So in this video, you learned about creating responsive sidebar menu with toggle option. I'll create next part of this website in the next video. If this video is helpful for you, please click on the like button and see you in the next video. Thank you so much for watching.